Hi everyone. So everyone's angry at me. I know the like and dislike is really low. The dislike is so high, and the like non-existent since part 1. So I just uploaded it 14 hours ago, I think. So a lot of people thinking I don't know what I was talking about. Yes, that is true. Part 1 is where I didn't really research their Twitter and never tried to understand everything that was on their bios. So I tried to research it, and boy, do I hate the community that tried to disintegrate their career even though they were just debuting. Because if you don't know, before this VTubers or Hololive English VTuber started, before even the debut, people were just trash talking them, thinking that they wouldn't really succeed on being a VTuber for Hololive, and thinking that they will all fall and all of this will subside and everyone on the Hololive English VTuber side would just fail, every single one of them. And when I saw that thread of community thinking that these people are just fake, they're just trying to entertain. Well, yeah, they're trying to entertain, making fun of everything, but there's a character in it that is humanizing it. It's not like it's all scripted and nothing was really unreal. When I saw this thread, oh my god, I hate it. But because of the thread, I discovered all of their Twitter, and I'm not going to share it yet. I'm not sure when will I share their Twitter, because as of right now, if anyone sees this, I don't want to see any bully threat on their Twitter, because Twitter is a cesspool of trash par, and I don't want to send any hate on their Twitter. So that's why nobody sends nobody makes a video just exposing them straight through. If you research these 5 YouTubers in Hololive English, you would hate just showing it in YouTube, because YouTube is a positive place. People help each other in it. But when I saw the thread, I forgot that the internet was so toxic. Because if you see this thread and see the people who exposed them, you wouldn't try to expose who's the real person. Because one of the members in Hololive has a face shown on the internet. So you gotta be careful. You don't want to make their lives in danger, because there are stalkers in Japan, and I don't want to be the one who makes this Hololive lives in danger, and I don't want them to be so traumatized in this genre, because the person I'm talking to was an idol from she wanted, I think, an idol or some star reputation of some sort, and failed on it, and Hololive helped her from becoming this famous person. And I don't want to expose her. Yeah, I'm going to give some clue every video of this part. So this is part 2, so and part 3 I'm going to explain some from Mori. But in this part 2, I'm going to explain why Kiara failed on trying to hide anything. And there's also with Amelia, who we all know, if you research enough, you will see her past video from Twitch. I'm not going to tell you what is her name or what is her Twitch and what is her Twitter, but you will see it, and I don't want to tell anyone. And even if you ask, before I even link it, I think I want a reaction from them. And if they think I can leak it, then I will leak it. But if they won't react, I won't do anything. I don't want to expose them, and I don't want to be responsible for their life being miserable. Because as much as possible, as I want it to be secretive, because one of them has been shown and face to face, we know who she is, we have seen her face and how much sacrifice she has done. I don't want to tell which one of those member is, and that's why if you think part one was really misinformation, yeah, I think it's misinformation because I didn't, I was just guessing, but this time I tried to research more and I found out a lot of things and how the community was so toxic that no one on YouTube would really try to just straight out show that their tweeters and any information about them in real life or anything that would expose them from this their past, because as of right now I'm really respecting them how far they have gotten from their past years. Because for example, Amelia started from Twitch in I think 2014, that's the last video, but maybe more, maybe she started at 2012, because if you're a thread reader, you would have seen that she bombed or nuclear bombed her Twitter and her Twitch and massively deleted all of his video on YouTube, so no one would see it. Yeah, I really respect them. And what I'm telling about you with Kiara is she became somewhat known but not really getting a lot of traction, so she gave up on her dream, and somehow Hololive found her because there was a little bit of success and tried to introduce her to this genre, and somehow she succeeded. So I'm really grateful that she succeeded on this career, because she was just saying on her live YouTube saying that if she wasn't called upon Hololive English, she would just have gone back to Austria and said, "Hey, I'm giving up my dream and I'm just going to work an office job, an 8-hour office job, and just slowly die from the inside and get married to some person that I like a little bit, and that's all. And that's the end of her story. That would have been her end of the story, but somehow Hololive gave her some little bit of hope, and maybe someday she can just remove herself from Hololive and be as famous as she is right now, but not as a VTuber, but something else. So that's all for part 2. This is a rush video because I was supposed to make this 4 hours or 8 hours ago, but I was pressed for time. Many people really made this video impossible to upload for tomorrow. So I really like, if you think this part 2 is great, if you don't like, you can just dislike. Thank you for viewing. That's all.